guys, welcome back to my channel. Today I'm filming another Will I Buy It video. I try to do these once a month. So if you guys have any products that you want me to talk about, definitely just tag me on Instagram and I would love to feature them in a Will I Buy It video. I usually just use the Trinboot Instagram page. She basically has all the new product updates that I need and she's quick and fast. And I also follow one called Hot Fire Makeup and that one's pretty good too, but I feel like Trinboot is definitely the biggest. So that's the one I follow most frequently. So the first thing I see on her page as I film this is the new Kevin Aucoin, The Making Faces, like, kit. So I think the book is included, and I'm gonna pop pictures of everything on the screen so you know what I'm talking about. But I have no real inclination to buy anything from Kevin Aucoin. I know a lot of people love, like, his contouring powder as well as some of his highlighters, but I just feel like that contour shade just does not, I don't think it'll work with my skin tone, so I don't plan on purchasing any of his products anytime soon. It's also one of those brands I feel like really caters to lighter skin tones, and that's totally okay with me, but they're very spendy, so I definitely am not planning on just picking it up, you know? The next thing I see on here, and I'm so excited for this collab, it was literally just announced, and it's the Desi x Katie collab with Dose of Colors. They are coming out with lipsticks, glosses, eyeshadow palette, two highlighters, two lipsticks, a whole bunch of stuff. And I've been looking at swatches recently. The only thing I'm really interested in is the eyeshadow palette. The shades look super pigmented. I also saw Luster Luxe. Katie had mentioned in comments on the products, like, people I guess are asking questions about the products, and she had mentioned that they created that quad, keeping in mind that people already have a bunch of matte palettes, so they kind of give you really bold shimmers, but like everyday neutral shimmers that you can wear with any of your other matte palettes. So that was pretty genius, and it looks like a pretty compact palette as well. The packaging reminds me of the Tarte blush palettes that come out around the holidays. It has that same shimmery, like, cloth texture to them, but that collab is coming out on August 14th, and it is definitely going to be something I'm picking up, at least the eyeshadow palette. I really don't need any highlighters or anything right now, but I'm definitely interested in supporting Desi and Katie. And yeah, I just can't wait to see, you know, how well this collaboration does. I have a feeling it's definitely gonna sell out. They're definitely well loved in the community. As far as the beauty community, they're not like overly snotty, they're not overly boasty, like, type people. Desi and Luster Luxe seem very down to earth. I think I found Katie's channel. She was probably one of the first YouTubers I watched, and she used to film, I almost thought she was in a hotel room because it was always so dark in the background, and I was like, does this lady travel for a living? Just because of her setup, it just looked like it was like in a dark hotel room. But I just remember her from before she quit her job and started doing YouTube full time, and I've been following Desi ever since. And they're just so stunningly beautiful, and they're just like goals, like everything goals. They're like one of the YouTubers like I wish I could be, you know? But anyway, so excited for that collab. Definitely let me know in the comments down below if you guys are planning on picking up anything from that collaboration. Next thing I see here, it looks like the fall 2017 Wet n Wild collection is called Mighty Mermaid, and honestly, I'm really not into anything mermaidy that much. Like, I really don't have like a mermaid like style by any means. Like, these earrings are pretty wild, but I just got these on clearance at Target, so it's not like I, you know, paid an arm and a leg for them, and I just thought they would be fun, you know, something for you guys to stare at during this video. But I'm not really into the mermaid thing, and even today I was at CVS and I saw that new Maybelline like rainbow highlighter, and I was like, oh, I should get that and like try it out, and I was like, for what? Like, I'm not into that, you know, color scheme. So Hard pass on that. Next thing I see, these are available right now. They're 6 palettes by MAC Cosmetics, and these are basically catered towards your personality. So the 6 palettes, there's the MAC Girl Basic B, Prissy Princess, Power Hungry, Mischief Mink, Fashion Fanatic, and Rocking Rebel. So just from those descriptions, you know, Rocking Rebel is like some bold shades, Basic Bitch is very like matte neutral, Fashion Fantic is like more purpley. I have no interest in any of these palettes. Maybe Mischief Minks, but I really need an eyeshadow palette. Like, I need a hole in my head. Right now, I have so many eyeshadow palettes that I actually can't even keep up with reviews for you guys. I've literally been just doing swatch videos and uploading them. And then I feel like every day I feel like this pressure to keep trying out different eyeshadow palettes because I have like so many pending reviews. So I was thinking today actually to try and invest in 4 items a month, because that way I can test each item for a week and give you guys a good review instead of constantly being stressed about reviewing stuff. I'm not saying too much makeup is a problem, but at some point you do really get overwhelmed. I really don't know how the big beauty gurus keep up. I actually like almost don't expect them to, but it is crazy. I mean, it is their full-time job to play with makeup and review it and present it to people, so I guess it's a little bit different. But when you have a full-time job and I just keep buying makeup, but I never have enough time to devote my full attention to one thing. So I'm definitely not going to buy any palettes except the Desi one, and I really want that Moschino collection, which I'm sure we'll talk about here. So the next thing I want to talk about is the new Beauty Blender. I guess it's called the Beauty Blender Pop, and it's like a limited edition summer beauty blender. I actually have a video coming up where I filmed all my favorite beauty sponges for you guys, and I basically don't understand why people pay $20 for a beauty blender anymore. I mean, don't get me wrong, I have a ton of beauty blenders, but I've found so many great drugstore alternates to beauty blenders that I personally plan on not buying any more beauty blenders. I really wanted that pink marble one that they came out with that was limited edition, but I was like, I don't need to spend $20 on this sponge. There's so many great ones that I like. So if you're interested in that video, definitely subscribe to my channel because it'll probably go up after this video. Huda Beauty is coming out with a new eyeshadow palette on September 18th called the Desert Dusks palette. Now, if you guys have been following me for a while, I really, really just had a hard time with the Huda eyeshadow palette because when it came out, it was so hyped up. You couldn't get it because it hadn't launched in the States yet. So I actually ordered it off of the Huda website and it shipped from Dubai. And I just thought it was so excessive. It was a very expensive palette, $75, I believe. Or you had to spend $75 to get free shipping. So she had it like all geared up where you basically had to spend $75 or you were gonna pay like $10 in shipping. So I just had a huge problem with her pricing. I didn't think the palette was worth the money at all. I seriously like cringe every time I see somebody buying that palette because I thought it was so worthless. But she's coming out with an eyeshadow palette and new foundation, and then her summer collection just launched in the United States, and I love the look of her summer highlighter palette, I'm not gonna lie. But every time I see it, I'm like, I don't need a highlighter palette, I don't need anything from Huda. But I'm not gonna lie, depending on what shades she puts in the palette, I might end up picking it up, but I'm definitely not gonna purchase it off of her website. I'm gonna wait until it actually comes to the United States. In case I hate it, I can return it so I'm not stuck with an overpriced palette. Next is the Kat Von D Everlasting Glimmer Whale. These are like metallic lipsticks and they're $22. They will be out August 22nd on Sephora. Now, here's my thing with metallic lips. I hate them. I think they're so weird, unwearable. I mean, where are you going on the daily that you can wear a metallic lip? Not gonna lie, it's really beautiful, but it's just not for me. I prefer to wear glitter on my eyes and keep my lips more neutral. But if you're really into a metallic lip, you should definitely go for it. She definitely has some crazy colors. Now, I haven't been able to talk about this in a Will I Buy It video, but the Kylie birthday collection, like, who is still buying Kylie Jenner makeup? It literally blows my mind that people are still buying Kylie cosmetics. And she is making so much bank. It's crazy. Like, and then she had that collab too with like Key Australia. I mean, she'll put her name on anything. If they say, Kylie, can we make a cheese with you? I'm sure she'll collab on that and call it like Attitude Cheese. And then everyone would buy it because Kylie Jenner collabed on a cheese, you know? It's just so cheesy. I mean, like, I just don't know why people are into Kylie Cosmetics. I mean, her lip glosses I like. Everything else is so basic, I just can't. I actually have two of her eyeshadow palettes from when she first launched her cosmetics collection. And I've been meaning to review them for you guys, but I haven't gotten around to it. But someday I will review Kylie Cosmetics for you guys. Jouer Cosmetics announced their collab with Jeffree Star. Now, why did that happen the same day Desi and Katie were previewing their line? Like, I just thought that was really weird timing, like almost like Jeffree was trying to steal their thunder. Maybe that wasn't the case at all, but that was the vibe I got. And then they like cut a cake and I was like, it's not his fucking birthday. Like, I don't understand the whole cake situation. It looked like they just threw it together last minute so he could just snap about it. And we all know Jeffree has the biggest following of like the beauty industry. So I'm sure he stole away like Katie and Desi's like limelight, which like I don't personally care, but I thought that was a little shady of him to do. So let me know if you guys thought that too, because I just thought it was strange timing, literally just out of nowhere. Like, they had been hinting they were collabing on their like Instagram and Snapchat stories, but I just thought the timing was really strange and it looked like they had just thrown that together last minute. So I'm interested to see what they're gonna come out with. I have a feeling it's a lipstick. He said it's gonna be one product and 100% of the profit will be donated to charity. The Dose of Colors Mint collection, you guys, that blue has been calling my name. If I was gonna make video on things I talked myself out of buying, that will be number one on the list right now, because that collection just like speaks to me on a higher spiritual level, just based off of the packaging. But I decided to pass on it because I really don't need it. And of course, Desi and Katie's collab is coming out by Dose of Colors, so why would I buy anything else from them, you know? Okay, and then the last thing I want to talk about in this video is the Too Faced Peach collection. And they are like teasing about it. They're having parties about it. So this collection will launch August 31st at Sephora in stores. Too Faced is one of those brands like I just can't with anymore. I literally haven't purchased things from them in so long, and I'm just basically done with them. Like, we're on a break. I think I bought the peanut butter and honey palette. That was the last one I bought, and I won't buy anything else from them until I hear some stunningly good reviews from multiple YouTubers. And I just can't with this peach nonsense. Like, just go watch any Will I Buy It video and you will see Too Faced in there. So I don't know who's still buying from them, but clearly they're staying afloat. So guys, those are all the products I wanted to talk to you about today. I hope you enjoyed this video. If you did, give it a thumbs up. Don't forget to subscribe to my channel down below and leave me a cool comment with any products that you want me to feature in this video series. Now, Will I Buy It's were created by Samantha Mark. She is a creator on YouTube and she does hers every Wednesday. So if you're interested in that, definitely check out her channel. Otherwise, I hope you guys have a great rest of your day. Thank you so much for watching my video and have a good one. Bye, guys.